What on earth is a simp?
That's a good question.
Simp. Suckers idolizing mediocre pussy.
Western masculinity in 2020 is a total dumpster fire, and because more and more men are behaving like simps, Western femininity has become a total dumpster fire too. Simps, enabled by social media, are encouraging and rewarding the very worst traits in women, which in turn ruins the chances of healthy, balanced, stable relationships.
What do we have here? You may kiss my boots.
Simp. Absolutely love your content, Sophie. Your cute little face and the tattoos are to die for, let alone your ass and tits. My girl could never. I'm sure your girl is just as beautiful. She is. She's an absolute sweetheart and I love her so much. Plan on spending the rest of my life with her. Simp.
From now on, like, every day, I'm going to give you money and all of my wages are going to go to you all the time because I think your life's perfect and your life should be so easy and I shouldn't have any money in my whole life. So I'm going to give you money all the time.
Yes, you will.
Yeah, so your alpha boyfriend is going to be invited to my house, my three-bedroom house, and he can treat it like it's his own. A stupid white loser does not deserve his own house.
Simp.
I love celebrities like Lizzo. I love that they're putting images out there that we normally don't get to see of bodies that we don't get to see being celebrated. And
why are we celebrating her body? Why does it matter? That's what I'm saying. Like, why aren't we celebrating her music? It isn't going to be awesome if she gets diabetes.
If you think that body shaming Lizzo is good content, then you're not 100% that bitch. You're just a bitch.
Simp.
Bruh.
My wife makes me pay for her premium Snapchat.
Bruh.
Simp.
I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star. Drinking in the bed, bitches jumping in the pool, and they ain't got on no.
Aliyu, if I pay you $5 again, will you follow me again? Yeah. What's your cash app again? Simp.
All the simping. Very, very disappointing. Disappointing!
Please get away from me.
The airplane.
Please get the hell away from me now.
Dude, back off.
Simp. Do you still need a computer? Yes. What's your cash app? MS Bakari, sent you enough for the MacBook Air, keep hustling. Sent $1,099.
What are you, morons?
Simp, 56,000 likes.
Bruh.
I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star. Drinking in the bed, bitches jumping in the pool.
Man, say something positive, uplifting, or defensive towards women. Men in the comments, hope she sees this, simp. For a gender that likes to, not all men, everyone to death, you sure do have a hard time believing there's men out there that don't share your misogynistic views. It brings me literal joy to read, I hope she reads this, bro, because it just means I know better than them, and that they've seen how it's supposed to be done. Even if they don't get the lesson right then, maybe later it'll sink in. She ain't gonna let you fuck, bro. Simp.
I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star.
Metro, what is simping and what is a simp? This is due to an outdated idea that men can only do nice things for women if they want to have sex with them. That's absolutely not true, and thankfully there are many healthy and platonic male-female friendships out there. Really? Like this one? We look so much like a couple here. Ha 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 ha! A couple of besties.
Bruh.
I don't like being told not to do something. Simp!
I've been in the hills, fucking superstars, feeling like a pop star.
But simps aren't just some obscure internet subculture, they're now literally part of the royal family. A dude who was once the epitome of rugged masculinity is now a simp.
Prince Harry, the most popular royal after the Queen, and his American wife Meghan, issuing what amounts to a declaration of independence.
We've chosen to make a transition this year in starting to carve out a progressive new role within this institution.
While responding to their decision, the palace released their own statement in which they revealed that...
Imagine being the most eligible bachelor in the world and you marry an older divorcee who forces you to resign from the royal family. You can't be a king and a simp. Harry, there's still time. Come home, lad.
He gonna find another girl and he won't miss ya.
I think Harry was a super prince, and I think when he married Meghan, he's changed completely, and I don't know why.
Rah.
But you know, just like Prince Harry, none of us are perfect, and we all slip up from time to time. Hey, it's Patrick Simpman, you're my lawyer, so I think you should know I've DM'd a lot of girls. Some trad girls from Kentucky, some goth girls, maybe 5 or 10, an art hoe I met on TikTok. I have the feet pics to prove it.
I mean, I guess I'm a pretty sick guy.
I did not make financial donations to that e-girl, but I guess it could always be worse. I guess your own daughter could be treating you like a simp.
Fuck, I got a little carried away with the shopping today, so now I have to unblock my dad on Instagram so he'll give me money. My dad hung up on me in the middle of me asking him for more money because his boss was calling. Men are trash! I don't know why I even go to class. All I do is complain about the slow Wi-Fi while I shop for clothes and harass my dad for more money.
Bruh.
I would kick my mama in the head while she sleeps just to eat.
Bruh.
Stop!
Hey guys, it's Kendall Jenner. Come get into bed with me.
No. I got what you
want, no, I cannot find. Return to tradition. But I guess it's hard for girls to return to tradition when their icons are on stage in front of a global audience celebrating killing a human life that was growing inside of them in exchange for a metal statue. I guess it's hard for them to embrace discipline, self-control, and delayed gratification when our culture venerates the exact opposite.
Diabetes. She's overweight.
I prefer really not to speak. If I speak, I am in big trouble. In big trouble, and I don't want to be in big trouble.
But thankfully, there's a courageous band of edgelords desperately trying to rescue their fellow man from the degenerate pitfalls of symptom. Hey! This is not funny, go away, never tweet me again.
You were very good. You played the situation perfectly.
Look, they say the family of the 21st century is made up of wipers and not relatives.
You love to see it, right? But here's the problem. There's an army of feminists flooding the internet with absolute bullshit about how they want men to behave like simps. When it's just not true. Ladies, what's something a guy did for you that you thought was the sweetest thing ever? This is horribly sad, but when he asked my consent and continued to do so during sex, is this okay? May I touch you here? Does this feel good? How do you feel? Talk to me! May I thrust again? 62% of women have rape fantasies, and those are the ones who admit to it. Fact is, the collapse of Western masculinity and simping has made young women exhibit and seek out increasingly more deviant sexual behaviour. Come on, I don't know a single woman who wants this. And she's right. These feminists are lying. Oh, is this okay? May I touch you here? No! Women hate that. It's basic biology for them to be repulsed by that behaviour. But I don't know, I guess if you eat enough Impossible Whoppers and read enough Vice magazine, you start to believe it. And before you know it, you're a simp. You want to get an Impossible Whopper sometime? Yes. A few weeks later, this man on my Snapchat pays me $20 every couple of days just for me to send a text saying I love him. Life is good. Simp! Exploiting a desperate, lonely man for cash. None of this is good. I would like to say he has in fact seen my tweet and does in fact think it's funny how upset people got about it, and also he sent me $50 for today's text, so thank you guys for keeping my wallet as fat as my ass. But Paul, simping is just an agreement between two parties. This is a fantastic example of free market capitalism. You should fully support this.
Could any hell be more horrible than now and real?
But again, it's important to emphasize that the simp cannot exist without the thought. I want you all to know that a dude picked me up from a party after we fucked, I blocked him, had another dude pick me up from his house, stayed the night with him, and then after he took me home, another dude took me out to lunch and I stayed the weekend with him. Which way, Western woman? Woke up. I still have depression and the horny. 2020 sucks. Yeah, I got depression, but I also got a fat pussy, so still a win. Whose dick do I have to suck to get rid of my depression? Really hope my depression gets depression so it'll be too unmotivated to fuck with me. My depression really gonna follow me to 2020 like man. Let me live. Constant sad posting about being depressed, combined with rampant promiscuity, not providing happiness. Some kind of connection here. How to get attention on Twitter. Strategy 1, strategy 2. Same thing on TikTok. If your daughter is on TikTok semi-naked twerking to hip-hop music for the benefit of a combination of hormone-crazy teenage boys and pedos, then you've totally failed as a parent.
Leave me alone!
Meanwhile, the one girl on TikTok who says not being sexually promiscuous is a good way to prevent STDs gets cancelled by an angry online hate mob radicalised by BuzzFeed. This is it. If a Muslim nurse was on TikTok saying drink water, go to bed early and praise Allah, she'd have been stand into next week. They say that 90% of women's eggs are gone by the age of 30. Thoughts are bathed in this simp social media culture of having a ready supply of male attention to call upon whenever they feel like it. The simps inflate the ego and the value of the thought, who then goes on Tinder and has a choice of men who are significantly more attractive than any of the simps. So the simps don't even get anything out of it. But eventually, the simps move on to younger women. The thoughts hit their 30s, and it's all downhill from there.
The toll will be paid. We're trying to warn you.
The end result of all this being both the simps and the thoughts end up desperate and lonely. Nobody has children. Western civilization collapses.
Find God, get married, have children, save Western civilization. Thank you and good night.
Simping is also another form of cuckoldry, which has become more prevalent for two reasons. One, testosterone levels in the West plummeting.
Impossible Whopper with a patty made from plants. Only at Burger King.
And two, weaponized social engineering that indoctrinates young men with the premise that their innate masculinity is toxic. My girlfriend's boyfriend is coming over for a threesome, so we prepared a snack table. Imagine seeing this and wanting to mock the people involved for having the hypest day.
Bruh.
Imagine thinking that some other dude banging your girlfriend is having the hypest day. I was raped by my wife's boyfriend, not sure the lifestyle is for me anymore.
Bruh.
Polyamory, expectations versus reality.
Their four-way relationship is working wonders for them.
And so who's the father of the baby?
What's the solution? Modesty culture? Islam? Sharia law? Based?
May Allah awaken the people and help them to see the evil doings of Israel.
Islam is sexist, racist, homophobic, transphobic, anti-Semitic, and a threat to our liberal democratic society.
Yes.
Disavow. Some people have called for even more radical action.
Life before women could use social media. Life after women started using social media.
After that, bitch, I'm trying to fuck you right. Now that, bitch, I'm trying to smash you right.
I am calling for a total and complete shutdown of females using social media until we can figure out what the hell is going on.
Disavow. But seriously, studies show relationships are way healthier and last way longer for people who meet in the real world, not online.
No e-girls. Ever.
Self-awareness check.
It's not a joke. Women online are nothing but trouble.
Sometimes you look back at girls you spent money on rather than send it to your mum and you realize that witchcraft is real. And that quote's totally not made up at all, but the fact remains. Social engineering, degeneracy, and porn have all exacerbated hypergamy and encouraged people to have more sexual partners than ever before, which in turn makes marriages more likely to fail, children more likely to grow up in broken homes, and everyone more likely to be depressed and suicidal. Tinder, TikTok, and basically all social media are just platforms for pimping and simping. Western relationships are totally screwed. Social media and its consequences have been a disaster for the human race. Is the conclusion that me making another pithy, pointless video about all this, where I'm rhetorically pissing in the wind to such a futile degree, that even 99% of the people watching will totally ignore everything I'm saying anyway? Yes, but even if I reach just a few people, it's all been worth it. To those people, I say, everything's gonna be okay.
Bruh.
It's all good, lads. We're all gonna make it.
Bruh.
It's absolutely crucial for you to help me fight the war on free speech by supporting me via Subscribestar. Link in description, and also signing up for my free newsletter at summit.news
/ newsletter.